is William Wallace, legendary Scottish freedom fighter, a man who took up a residence in the Scottish borders and repelled the advancing English armies who wanted Scotland as their own. Wallace is an extremely well-known character in Scottish history and Scottish folklore. I think what a lot of people don't understand is how strong his connections were to the Scottish borders though. He spent most of his time here during the Wars of Independence in the Ettrick Forest, hitting attacking English armies and also attacking the English in England. I think even this magnificent, huge statue of Wallace right in the heart of the Scottish borders is relatively unknown and relatively forgotten. But it shows how much people in the 19th century, long before Mel Gibson came on the scene, applauded and appreciated what Wallace did for Scotland during the Wars of Independence. During those wars of independence, Wallace's archenemy was English King Edward I, Edward Longshanks. A man who committed some evil and vile acts like the sacking of Berwick, where almost every inhabitant of the town was murdered. Surely, nobody, not even on the English side, applaud this man.
The peerless knights of Elderslie, who waved on Ayr's romantic shore the beany torch of liberty, and roaming round from sea to sea, from glade obscure of gloomy rock, his bold companions called to free the realm from Edward's iron yoke.
But there are monuments to Edward Longshanks. And I'm not talking about in London. I'm talking about just a few miles over the border. This is the Solway Firth, near the small village of Burgh-on-Sands, the gateway to Scotland for any invading English armies. The quickest route right across the Solway Firth there to the Loch Maidstone on the other side. But here lies a monument to Longshanks. Can we find it? In July 1307, the English forces had mustered here, led by Longshanks himself, ready for another push across the Solway into Scotland. But Longshanks was old. He was old and he was ill, And it was on this exact spot here, on the marshes, that he collapsed and died. This monument was built in 1685, 300 years ago, to mark the exact spot where Edward Longshanks died. This huge, huge structure is a mark of respect for the man who some English people believe was England's greatest ever king. On. How could the evil tyrant, the man who destroyed Wales, the hammer of the Scots, how could this evil creature possibly be England's greatest ever king? Perhaps the monument there is just a celebration of him dying. Anyway, after Longshanks had died, he was taken from the marshes here to the close by village of Burgh and laid to rest in the church until he was moved to Westminster Abbey. Let's go and take a look at Burgh and the church and see if Longshanks is remembered there also. This is the small and sleepy village of Burgh, but for a small and sleepy village, it packs a massive punch in terms of history. You see, not only was Burgh the place where King Edward's life ended, but it was the place where Hadrian's Wall began on the west coast. And if you think the bricks in this church look familiar, it's because they're all plundered from Hadrian's Wall. Surely they don't celebrate the life of the tyrant Edward I here, do they? But they do celebrate the life of Edward I in this village, this English village. Now, whether that's genuine affection or a clever ploy to draw in tourists, I don't know. But they've certainly put up a statue of him less than 10 years ago. And here he is, looking all young and powerful and heroic and all-conquering. Less than 10 miles from the Scottish border and the Scottish borders, Edward Longshanks, a celebratory statue of his life and his achievements. Can you believe that? Well, I can believe it. It's just a matter of geography, really, isn't it? Whatever side of the divide you're born on, you're brought up with one guy as a hero and the other as a tyrant. Luckily for me, I was brought up on the Scottish side, so I get the true story. There's a strange irony to the whole situation. Now, in the English borders, they praise Edward Longshanks, and the Scottish borders were praising William Wallace. But the Wars of Independence ripped apart, destroyed the whole of the borderlands, English and Scottish. We were basically all one people. The place was routed time and time again by English and Scottish armies and became a wasteland, forgotten. But even to this day still, both sides of the imaginary divide praise the heroes of that war. Propaganda. Be careful what you believe, wherever you come from. Poor planning from me there, really. I really should have brought a Scottish flag to tie on that statue. Next time.